5 seconds to go. Start. I shall now give a brief survey of the provisions in the bill which are designed to encourage investments in productive enterprises to stimulate higher productivity as well as exports and to provide resources for expansion of industry. In order to encourage investment by individuals and Hindu undivided families in the equity shares of new industrial companies in India, provision has been made for the grant of tax-free tax credit certificates to them with reference to their subscriptions to eligible issues of capital by such companies for a period of 4 financial years commencing with the financial year in which the investment is made. The amount of the tax credit certificates is to be calculated at a slab system of rates and will be limited to ₹1,250 for each financial year on a total investment of ₹30,000. Under the original provision in the bill, only the first subscriber to eligible issues of capital qualifies for the tax credit certificates. Considering the fact that a substantial part of the capital issues made in recent months has had to be taken up and is still held by financial institutions which underwrote those issues, the eligibility for tax credit certificates has been extended to individuals and Hindu undivided families who purchase shares forming part of an eligible issue of capital from an underwriter declared as such in the relevant prospectus. Incentives for increased industrial production as well as for the more efficient use of the capital already invested are provided in the form of tax credit certificates calculated with reference to the central excise duty payable on increased production in the relevant year over that of the base year and with reference to the additional amount of corporation tax payable by a company in the relevant year over that payable by it in the base year. The amount of the tax credit certificates granted for these purposes is required to be used for discharging debt obligations, acquisition of capital assets in India, including construction of a building for the purpose of the business and, in the case of a company, also for the redemptions of its debentures. This would enable industrial units to pay off the monies which they had borrowed for expanding their productive capacity or alternatively to plow back a larger portion of their current earnings for the purpose of expansion. As stated in the Finance Minister's budget speech, it is necessary to provide some more assistance to our export industry on a discriminating and selective basis in order to mitigate the disadvantages under which it operates in the foreign market and to help it achieve its full competitive position. The tax credit certificates to be issued with reference to the value of exports will, I expect, provide an impetus for increasing our export potential and augment our foreign exchange earnings. In this connection, it is proposed to set up an advisory board on tax credit certificates for our exports to advise government regarding the commodities for which the certificates should be granted, as also the rates. The board will, wherever necessary, invite the commercial interests concerned to present their views before it. The Commerce Secretary will be the chairman of the board and a senior officer, each from the Ministry of Finance and the ministry in charge of the export commodity concerned, will be members. The recommendations of the board will enable the government to take informed decisions with regard to the grant of these certificates. The measures for encouraging investment of surplus funds in production channels include a provision for revival in a modified form of the exemption from wealth tax of individuals and Hindu undivided families on the value of their investments in equity shares of industrial companies. This exemption will be available to individuals and Hindu undivided families on the value of any equity shares held by them in an industrial company where such shares form part of the initial issue of equity share capital made by the company after the 31st March 1980 and will extend over a period of 5 successive assessment years commencing with the assessment year next following the date on which the company commences the operations for which it has been established. Madam, the bill contains a scheme for voluntary disclosure of unaccounted income during a period of 3 months from 1st March to 31st May 1985. Tax is payable on the amount declared at the ad hoc rate of 60% with a rebate of 5% of the tax where the declaration has been made and the tax has been paid not later than the 31st March 1985, where the declarant is unable to pay the tax on the amount declared immediately, he has the option to pay it within a period of 6 months from the date of declaration, provided he furnishes adequate security in the form of a guarantee from a scheduled bank. Stop.